Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Rosero Game Stage. To celebrate the launch of Assassin's Creed Syndicate, we are now about to play some Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
It'd be weird if we played something else.
Yes, it would be, right? To celebrate the launch of Assassin's Creed, we're playing Guitar Hero. I'm joined by Rich and Julia. Thank you very much, folks.
Hello.
Rich, you finished this, you reviewed it, so we're going to be taking questions from the audience throughout. If you have any questions, just ask us. Just give us a kind of a backdrop to what we are playing now, because this isn't the beginning of the game, this is how far in, and there's no spoilers, right? We're going to keep it spoiler-free-ish.
This is spoiler-free. So this is one of the missions you do about sequence four, I think. So it's about halfway or just before halfway in the game. You're at Lambeth Asylum, and you're tasked with assassinating this doctor, and he's a bit of a nasty piece of work, as you'll see. And there's several ways in which you can approach this. You have a unique kill opportunity that you'll see.
We're going to try and do that, right?
We're going to try and do it like by the book, like do it all properly, because the unique kill opportunity is pretty cool.
No pressure,
Dan. No pressure, mate. But I did it first time perfectly.
Okay, mate.
So if you deviate anywhere from the set route, you suck.
Okay, so you're going to guide me.
Yeah, I'm going to try and help you through it, all right?
But first, a cutscene.
You might need to invert your controls too,
Dan. I will need to invert
because
the controls.
Your brain is in backwards.
I trust that you had a productive
so this
meeting
is
with Mr.
Darwin.
Owen.
Oh, yes, right, we had the most wonderful chat. I found out the man
exactly
behind Steric's soothing syrup is John Elliott.
Dr. Elliotson, I haven't heard that name in a long while. He was a brilliant heart specialist until he became obsessed with phrenology and mesmerism.
Mine's better.
Ruined his career. Well, how shall we proceed?
Oh, with all respect, Mr. Darwin, I believe I should proceed alone. After all, we wouldn't want to attract any unwanted attention.
Sounds very wise. Good luck, my boy. Mr. Fry, should you find yourself with any free time, please do call on me.
I never thought of it like that, but yeah, I guess maybe
that is
part of it. Yeah.
Then they can't procreate.
Absolutely, natural selection. So yeah, Dan's just going to invert his controls. You'll also notice that Jacob, who we're playing as here, he's wearing the Master Assassin armor because I'm awesome and I unlocked it and crafted it. But there's all sorts of different outfits that you can
just
craft
throw that
and
in
stuff.
There casually, like, oh, well, I'm really cool.
You know, I'm amazing. But there you go. Yeah.
Thanks for being so awesome, Rich.
That's all right.
So here we are. Look at this.
So you've got like all the tools unlocked as well.
Okay.
You've got the Master Assassin outfit. You've got the Edge here, Dan.
Right.
I'm just trying to.
You literally can't mess it up.
Okay.
It's really embarrassing for you.
I haven't played much of this, so this could be interesting.
So in this one, you can also press A to sneak. So he'll put his hat away and put his hood up.
Here we go.
So that's useful.
I've done that much.
Yeah.
It's also
good.
It's raining and he might want to not get his hair wet.
Exactly. He's got lovely hair.
No.
So these are your guys, you can recruit them, but I wouldn't recommend doing that now because you don't really need them.
Are we going stealth?
Just as a side note.
So are we going up, Rich? Give us some guidance.
Well, on the map, the mini-map, you see those arrows? Those are your multiple entry points, so you can choose any one of those you like. And that left bumper prompt is your rope launcher, so you can zip straight up to the roof if you want and enter that way.
Just thought I'd climb. Old school Assassin's Creed.
Yeah, go for it. So but you'll see we're in London because it's raining. And it always rains in London every single day.
Really?
Yeah,
is that
apparently.
How you know that we're in London?
That's how you know we're in London.
Because it's raining.
And look at that grey sky. It's proper London.
Just thought I'd get up here and see what it's like.
So, yeah, like every Assassin's Creed game, you've still got your sync points. These act as fast travel points as well. So, classic Assassin's Creed, really.
I was just trying to find out where I can jump.
Leaps of faith now as well. You have to press B to do them, so there's no way you can accidentally jump off the edge. I think that's good, because I used to do that every now and again. I'd accidentally fly off the edge of a building.
Edge. Yeah. So annoying.
Do you have any advice for us about which way to go, or should we just take one?
Follow
your heart, Dan.
But it's a sandbox. There's loads of different ways in.
Yeah, well, so just...
Yes. This is what it's about. It's about freedom. You know, you choose which entry point
right,
you want.
We're going to go for the one.
But there's no wrong answers, Dan. Exactly, like life.
Choose
whatever
entry point you want.
Okay.
Exactly. You're going in through the front door, Dan. Really?
No. Well, you just said I could choose whichever one I wanted.
Yeah, like choose whatever that.
Not the front door. Okay. I mean, that's basic.
All right. What's this one? Is this the front door? Or the side door?
I don't know. I think you should just go with that. There we go. Nice little side entry point.
Right.
Lovely.
Let's go sneaky.
This is different to what I did. So, also, you'll see that little indicator on Jacob. That's showing, obviously, an audio cue as to where enemies are. And you've got your eagle vision, so you can see enemies through walls because I've upgraded it a bit. Usually it's a bit more pared down than that when you start, but you've got a skill tree, so you can buy two extra levels of eagle vision that add more kind of layers to it.
Eagleness.
More eagleness, extra eagleness. Oh, wow, you've basically entered right into the thick of it. So these are all patients milling around here. So, yeah, if you disturb any of them, they're going to kick off.
So don't disturb anyone.
Yeah, I won't disturb them if you can help it. And all
just
these guys...
Just jump into the middle of them.
yeah, why not? Go on, Dan, let's mix it up.
Yeah.
Okay. You've got orderlies as well, these blue guys. So, strictly
Where
speaking, they're
I
not enemies. Because enemies are usually red, so they're actually kind of just people doing their job. So you should feel really bad if you kill any of them. Because they had, like... families and stuff.
I don't feel bad.
They're just
no,
there
no one
working.
About the life of the henchman.
No, exactly, right?
So what's this, Austin Powers, right?
So this is our target here, and as you'll see, he's not a very nice guy. This is what they used to do back then.
Yeah. Just think that corkscrew in your head. That'll sort you out.
Yeah, if you're
dead.
If you're of a sensitive disposition, it's too late. You've already seen it. But,
Is there anybody under the age of 18 here?
As you just witnessed, the application of too
exactly,
much pressure
yeah.
can
he
sometimes result in unexpected outcomes. Unfortunately, it appears I've ruined
the it was a dark time, wasn't it? Victorian London.
They just always seemed to think they knew what they were doing, and it was always utterly grotesque.
Horrible. Awful.
Send up a cadaver.
Have you been to actually any of the old, like, medical facilities
in
London?
Dr. Linton.
No.
Might have been to one, and there was loads of weird stuff in formaldehyde.
Oh, yeah.
Just creepy. Frightening. Yeah.
Let me just cut off your leg. Here,
I don't care about your
damn
exactly.
And I care even less about your damn patience.
You might feel the bite of a hacksaw
kids.
As I. Nasty. So, yeah, this is setting up all the different opportunities
you
you've got now, Dan. So, you can steal the key,
now
find
off.
Your way in that way. Reconnect the controller. Oh, we charged the batteries and everything.
I think that might be a wireless thing.
So you've got the nurse as an infiltration opportunity. You've got the young doctor who's calling to for another cadaver as your unique kill opportunity.
All right, you're going to talk us through this step by
step. Okay, well, the way I did it is I went for the key first because that means you can move around freely. You're not restricted.
Okay.
Do it.
So you can open any door. I mean, if you were stupid, you could just jump in and try and assassinate him right off the bat.
That sounds more like what I would do, but by accident.
Yeah.
Like, whoops, sorry, everyone.
That's going to be a tough escape because everyone's going to be drawn to you immediately. So, and these extra objectives as well you can take on if you want, Dan. Like, do not fire a single bullet. And halt the electroconvulsive therapy session. That was the bit you saw in the cutscene. So if you take out the two orderlies there.
You can get that
bonus objective.
Why isn't it good now? There we go.
You do the controlled descent now with B.
Right, we're heading towards the nurse.
So, yeah, the nurse is down there. You can come in through that entry point and down and talk to her. To do these things, you've got to remain anonymous as well. So if you raise suspicion, you won't be able to talk to her and you'll have to wait for another opportunity. So there you go. There's an enter button now because people used to get frustrated with getting in windows. I don't know if anyone played Assassin's Creed Unity, but that was a bit of a frustrating thing.
Can I assassinate her?
Yeah, just one of, should we say a few problems? No.
Can I kill her?
No, I don't think you can, actually. But yeah, I mean, if you did play Unity and you're thinking this is as kind of glitchy as that one was, it's not.
One of the brutes stole my
key
and there's no
one
around. I can't get out of here.
Stole your key. Don't go anywhere. I might be able to do something.
Quite. Thank you, sir.
So she's not suspicious of you being there. She's like,
find me,
sir. Just random guy.
Well, go on now, sir.
Absolutely.
I will wait.
She's
here.
Not suspicious that I'm knelt down now either.
It's perfectly normal.
Right, so
hooded figure.
Well, you know, in those times,
prowling
people
around.
Probably had quite a lot of conditions in the back.
Yeah.
Just hunched anyway.
Absolutely, yeah. He's been working
Dr.
in the mines
Elliot
or whatever.
Cannot
yeah.
be allowed to continue his experimentation.
So I've got another target now.
So Dan, I mean, you could just go through the corridors and try and evade people. But you need to steal the master key. She's just told you where the key is.
Yeah, and it's
I would personally go back.
Can I not get in this way?
You can if you want, but.
All right, Rich.
I'm just trying to help.
You were going to guide me, so.
Part of me wants to see you doing it your way,
right.
So I'm going to gently guide you. I'm not going to try.
I can't imagine Dan Webb is a master of subtlety and stealth.
Oh no, aggressive stealth is the term that Dan's coined for himself.
Really?
That's how he does
what,
things.
Just shouting.
Yeah, pretty much.
Running into rooms.
Yeah, so I don't know how the stealth bit works because they're kind of conflicting terms, aren't they? Aggressive stealth. So yeah, once you get to the guy you need to steal the key from, you need to hold B. And that will steal the key off him, hopefully.
What will happen if I walk up to that guy? Will he run away?
He might grow suspicious. Do you know what, Dan?
Can I kill him?
You could just kill
him. Just wing it.
Just kill him. I think people would be disappointed if they came to see a session creep and didn't see you stab someone up with a hidden blade. You can also knock them out non-lethally, actually.
So I probably
should have mentioned
that. Okay, thanks, Rich.
Yeah. Stab him in his neck.
Yeah, if you hold B behind them now, you can quietly knock them out. Yeah. Chuck him in there with B.
That went well.
Okay,
threw him with X.
Yeah, I just wanted to see what I could throw him in.
Put him in the cupboard.
There we go.
There we go.
No one will suspect a thing.
Right.
No, apart from the blood.
Here we go.
CPAP, but you know.
We have a target.
Exactly, bit of blood. These things happen.
Probably it's quite a nice parquet floor that might get a bit annoyed if you get blood on it.
That's true, yeah. Stain that parquet floor. So yeah, you've
Look at those chops.
I know.
They're great, right?
Jealous.
Wait, have you ever been tempted just to shave off a little bit?
Just shave this bit. I could, couldn't I? I could rock that look. I don't know if I'd get away with it.
You could just hang out in East London and no one's back right.
Exactly.
I'm going to go for it.
Okay, okay. You're going non-lethal then?
Yeah. Well.
Oh, whoops.
Careful.
Oh,
I've seen you.
No. Punch him in his groin.
There we go. So you can actually.
Have I got the key?
Yeah, no one else has suspected you, funnily enough.
That's really.
You got away with
maybe
that.
Maybe they don't like old Chopsy there.
Yeah, maybe.
Just like punch him in his face. That guy's an idiot.
So
Dan, inadvertently.
I have a hostage.
You've actually got a hostage who you can use to escort you to different places as long as you don't get too close to other people.
Okay.
So people will think that you're just going for a nice walk with your friend.
Oh, he's a bit drunk.
Through the hospital.
You know, everyone was drunk all the time.
Exactly,
right?
yeah. Normally you'd have to restrain this guy by tapping A, but there's an upgrade that means you don't have to do that, called intimidation. So he's scared of you, and he won't try and break free.
Okay, so where's the unique kill, Rich? Come on, let's do it.
Right, okay, so now you've got the master key. If you use Eagle Vision, you can see the door you need to get through somewhere.
There.
So it'll be marked in white. So it might be there. I think that's the door. Yeah, that is the door. So yeah, if you go through that door, and then you can go down into the basement, I believe, and that's where you'll find your unique kill opportunity.
Okay. I feel like I should get rid of this guy.
Yeah, you can bin him. You can, if you hold B, you'll knock him out.
Yeah, is there any way I can hide him?
Yeah, go on. Nah, leave him.
No, all right.
No one will find him.
Take that.
No. You have to hold B. Before you let someone... What are you doing?
I'm holding it.
Oh, do you know what? This has not gone well.
Just mess him up, Dan.
There we go.
Wow,
I just meant punch him. I didn't mean to cut his head off.
So that's a new weapon as well, the kukri. Like a blade. It's quite brutal. But you can also have knuckle dusters or a cane sword, like a concealed blade.
And it changes character.
No, you can have any weapon between any character. So Evie can also have the kukri or the cane knuckle dusters.
Okay.
Yeah.
But she has slightly different kind of skill set, right?
She's
left kind of punching in the face.
Exactly. I mean, you can go that way with her. I was doing some Fight Club missions with her last night. She's a badass.
Really?
In the ring, yeah. So, she can have any weapons she wants, but she's also more kind of designed towards stealthy approach. So
yeah.
She's got special skills just for her that make her more stealthy. Like, by the time you level her up to level 10...
I've just gone round in a circle.
Nice. She can turn invisible when she stays still, which is a bit weird, but kind of cool. So, yeah.
Who's this guy on the...
Just hang out. I don't feel like you're progressing anyway, Dan.
No,
I feel like you've been here already.
No, would you like more guidance?
I'm going down to the...
You want to get down to the basement, basically.
Yeah,
so
nothing good ever
down.
Happens in a basement.
Well, exactly. It's where they keep the cadavers. Ooh. But you can see in there, it's that pink skull icon downstairs. So that's where you need to go, Dan.
I'm heading there.
They're going to think there's some sort of carbon monoxide leak in
the
building.
Because
all the people just asleep on the floor.
Everyone's just collapsed.
Oh, he's just drunk on duty again.
What are you doing? You're going out and then in again.
Yeah.
You know we're meant to be showing off all the different things in the game, not the same bit that we did sort of 2 minutes ago, right?
It's stealth.
That's not stealth. That's just going round in circles.
It's stealth, look. See, I want to get in that door. Now I've got the key, so I'm going back.
On our Twitch chat, Dan, people are calling for you to open the inventory and spend half an hour in there, like you usually do.
Sure.
Yeah, everyone loves a menu, right?
Exactly. That's Dan's thing. What, he loves a bit of inventory management. He does.
I'm going to stick this over here, and then maybe combine that.
Exactly.
There's nothing finer. Oh, that guy's going to see me.
Has no one done, like, a website or, like, Twitch, just of, like, you know, stuff you get in games? I feel like that should be a thing.
It should, right?
Like
definitely.
Anal inventory or something.
Yeah, and Dan is one of those people. Absolutely.
Notorious.
He is.
So how do I get downstairs?
It is now. It is now. We just made it up. We just coined it.
How do I get downstairs? Do I have to go through that door there?
You could sneak through here and go sort of under, over and under. Does that make sense?
How do I get down without them seeing me there?
With great difficulty.
How did you get in, Rich?
Do you know what?
The worst guide ever.
To be honest, Dan, I actually did kill everyone.
Oh, did you really?
I just had the free run of the place. Because if you kill everyone, there's no one to detect you anymore.
Okay. That's one way of doing it, right. Although you have just killed a bunch of innocent people. Did you kill all the mental patients as well?
Oh, no.
You
I
left
didn't
them
do that.
Alone.
Yeah.
You're not a complete monster.
I think the only way you can actually kill innocents in this one is actually aiming and throwing a knife or firing a bullet at them. And it'll say, warning, assassins did not kill civilians. And if you keep doing it, it'll game over. Yeah. It's always done that in Assassin's Creed.
I seem to be back here again.
What, oh my god, Dan!
Just keep heading down. Just keep heading down. Do you know what? Just go over there. Air assassinate him. Go on.
Saw that.
Take him out. Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, he's done. Right. Left. Take him out by the fireplace because I don't like the look of him.
He looks sinister.
He looks shifty.
He needs to also be doing some work.
His legs are probably burning. He's got hot
shins
by that fire.
Everyone's
he's
going down.
He's done him a favour,
basically.
Exactly. He would have had hot legs and would have alleviated that problem by murdering him.
His red hot shins have been cured.
Right, here we go.
Go through that. Yeah, right. Through that.
I really feel like we're going round in circles.
Double assassinate these two. Go on. Just kill them all.
Just do
all
it.
Then.
Just slap them.
Hold
whatever
on.
You
hold
do.
On.
Kill them all and let God sort them out, right? Is that what they say?
Wow.
There you go. Lovely. Right, now left. Left. That's the door you need to pick on the left there. So open that.
Yes.
But don't go in.
Right? Don't go in.
That's the theatre, so that helps later on. So we've set that up, that's good. Right, so carry on. Double assassinate these two guys.
Oh,
they're suspicious. Oh, if you press down on the D-pad, you can also whistle them. And now, if you're in cover, you can cover assassinate this guy.
Come on, Eric, you got a gun!
Right, now the other guy's wise to you. It really does help that I'm maxed out here because the fights aren't much of
no,
an
mate. It's just
don't,
the skills.
No!
Go round. Left. Okay. Through that doorway. Yeah. Right,
kill him.
Quiet. Easy does it. Right. Take a right, I think.
Hold on.
Yeah, okay,
we're just taking it.
Not taking it.
Wait, that dude over there is wise. Coming.
You ready?
Coming.
You ready?
Coming.
You ready? It's coming in this way.
Yeah, there we go.
What do you get on the wall?
I think he's going the other way, Dan. I think he's safe.
Oh.
Yeah, you're fine. He hasn't got a clue.
So just kill him anyway.
This is what Dan means by that's aggressive stealth. There you go. He shouldn't have started to look for me. Yeah.
Right, let's go again.
Okay, right.
Back into stealth mode.
So don't go in there yet because that's where you need to end up.
You're the worst guide ever.
I am, aren't I? My memory's awful. I can't remember the way to go now.
Oh my god.
You can just go up behind him and assassinate him if you want.
But you're going to kill 4 million other people anyway.
What are we doing? Go on then. Let's skip to the end. Let's take him out.
Your presence in London has not gone unnoticed.
Hey guys.
See you guys.
There we go.
See ya.
and that's the quick and easy way of doing it.
I could have done that hours ago. I wanted to do the unique kill.
Well, the unique kill you get, you replace the cadaver that he called for, and you pop up from
the last
to
kill him.
That's cool.
So it's kind of cool. I thought.
Yes, I can.
And then Rich failed at navigating.
I forgot where to go.
A better tomorrow, forged with the blood of visionaries.
All I see is the blood of a lunatic.
You truly believe murdering an old man would stop humanity's great architect? Crawford's
sure.
Glorious design.
Does anyone have any questions they want to ask so far?
Designs are meant to be broken.
Show of hands, no one.
We are doing our job.
No,
a child.
Yeah, I guess so.
Can solve all the world's woes with a flick of a blade.
No one in the Twitch.
Have you ever seen that? Everyone's completely satisfied.
Actions, Jacob Fry.
I think they were just pleased you weren't going around
himself. Or did your father teach you nothing?
That's a bit overdramatic.
They do this weird thing together. Now where they get a handkerchief and swipe the blood away from the neck. And I don't know what that's all about.
Aw. We used to be in love.
It's bizarre.
And it ended so tragically.
So they just have a collection of bloody handkerchiefs. Which is kind of weird, isn't it?
Sniff it.
It is a little weird, right?
It's bizarre. Like very strange.
Unless he's like cloning them.
Oh, wow. Maybe, ooh. Yeah. Maybe.
That's not a thing.
Right.
I'm not reading that bin bag.
No one seems that bothered that you just, in front of a whole group of people, just totally stabbed a dude.
No, right?
Yeah. So now you just got to get out.
Oh, well, maybe it's because everybody's dead. You killed everybody already.
That could be it. Exactly. Like. So just leave casually, like nothing happened.
Living the dream.
Yeah. So what are you going to do next, Dan? Are you going to walk around the open world for a bit, or do you want another sequence?
Yeah, should we have a wander around the open world?
Yeah, okay.
Just go out the front door.
You could, couldn't you? We like to leave in style, right?
Do you?
Through the window.
You want something that's the opposite.
We don't use doors. Assassins don't use doors. So you could drive off in the carriage. There you go,
Dan.
That's the way.
There we go. Lovely.
Look at that. Nice and casual.
Turn to turn.
That's a girl.
There we go.
Well done, Daniel. Well done. So we got one of the two extra objectives as well.
Shocking.
It's good work. No, it wasn't shocking. It was good.
We should have got both, good. Rich.
I'm sorry.
You failed.
I couldn't find I couldn't
guidance.
Remember where the basement was. Yeah.
I always forget things when I play video games. Like, you do it, and then someone's like, oh, what about that bit? And you're like, I have no idea what I did. Or, like, the names of main characters. Forget them.
We've got a question here. So, who is the main baddie, and how much modern-day stuff is there, someone asks. Okay, so the main baddie is a guy called Crawford Starrick. And
is
he's
he
basically,
real?
He's not. I don't think he's based on a real person. And he's like kind of the head templar, he's top of the kind of food chain in London. And basically you got to take him out and his lieutenants. Yeah, I've seen him. And how much modern day stuff is there, someone asked. It's all kind of relegated to cutscenes this time. So not much is the answer to that question, unfortunately. And none of it's playable. So you're mostly spending your time in Victorian London. So there you
awesome.
Go. So yeah, question from the audience.
What's your question?
You have to have played all the other Assassin's Creed games, because I haven't finished Unity yet. Or is this a pick up and play a separate game?
I feel like you can pick up and play this one. You might be ever so slightly lost with the present day stuff, although there wasn't really much of that in Unity either. So it's mostly kind of focused on the Victorian London, and it's its own kind of standalone story. So I don't think you'd miss out if you haven't finished Unity. I think you could go straight into this and enjoy it.
Yeah. Any other questions while I'm here? He's finished the game, so he knows lots.
Ooh. We seem to have started on a street fight with the police.
Okay, we got another question.
Yeah.
Compared to the lovely and wonderful Ezio, how does Jacob and Evie stand up to his legend?
I love Ezio too. I think he's still the best assassin in the series. But I actually quite liked Jacob and Evie. I like their kind of banter. They have an interesting relationship, and it kind of develops quite nicely over time. You feel like there's a weird bit of history between them, and they really kind of grow on you. I ended up liking them by the end, and I actually wanted to spend more time with them. Well, it's because you don't really understand what's going on with their relationship, and it's just cool to see it develop. And yeah, it's an interesting dynamic. And they play quite differently too. I actually played most of the game as Evie because I thought, you know, it'd be cool to be a female assassin for a change. And she's really, really awesome. So, yeah, I think you'll like it.
Any other questions? Might think of something
soon,
and then I'll come back.
I'll just check the Twitch.
You're just
chat
causing
again.
Mayhem, Dan. Ram some stuff.
Okay, we've got a question here. When you finish the game, is there a free roam mode? If so, can you swap between the two characters any time? Yes, you can swap by pausing it and pushing in the right stick. You have to be on the ground though, and not riding around or whatever when you do it. You're free to obviously roam the city and finish any collectibles or side missions you haven't done. Because there's a kind of overarching kind of thing where you've got to conquer all the territories. So the thing is, I've conquered the whole of London. I've pretty much done everything. Although there's a load
amazing.
Of... it does look really good. And it's really just nice and smooth this time too.
Yeah.
I saw maybe two or three minor things.
But like not seeing inside people's heads
exactly,
or anything like that.
Nothing on that level, no. So Dan, yeah, if you wanted, you could hit the back button or whatever it's called now, and you can see the whole map if you zoom out with the triggers. So yeah, you've got all these districts, so you basically do different objectives.
Southwark,
and
Whitechapel, City of London.
Exactly, yeah. You conquer all these places. So you've got St. Paul's Cathedral as well. And
how accurate is it as well? Like, could you theoretically, as a Londoner, kind of already know what you're doing? Or is it completely made up?
Kind of. They said that the train stuff is essentially made up because basically all trains in London went out of the city at the time, apparently. But they wanted the whole sort of fantasy of that industrial age, and that's why they put kind of a big ring around the city. And
is that also so that if you're trying to do stuff on a train, it doesn't just end?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. So it kind of goes round in circles.
It's like a fake circle line.
Yeah, and your HQ is on a train, which is constantly chugging around as well, so that's cool. You can fast travel back to it at any time, so that's cool.
You don't have to, like, top up your Oyster or anything, because I could not be bothered to do that.
That'd be amazing, though, if you had to. If you had to buy tickets and stuff. Yeah, absolutely. Ollie says, do you go anywhere else other than London at any point? Hashtag no spoilers. Without spoiling anything, there is, one other place you can go. And that's a kind of extended bunch of missions that you discover at one point in the game. Just a little thing appears on the map, and I won't spoil it by saying what it is, but it's pretty cool. Okay, we're in the city of London now, so...
So what kind of landmarks can you see as well?
Well, obviously, Big Ben or St. Stephen's Tower, or whatever it's supposed to be called, House of Parliament and all that, Westminster Abbey. Paul's Cathedral, obviously, which I've already said, Lambeth Asylum.
Do you get to go through, like, Traitor's Gate? Because, like, obviously in the original Tower of London, they had an entry on the river where all the traitors would come through.
Yeah, is that in the water?
Yeah, in the water, but they've closed it. Can you see it now? It's blocked in.
So yeah, you can.
Oh, cool.
Can. In fact, there's a mission where I exited through Traitor's Gate. And
I've always wanted to go to Traitor's Gate.
Yeah, so Tower of London, that's another one.
I'm too lazy to commit treason, though. Can't
be bothered. Who can be bothered these days?
So much good stuff on TV. Great video games.
Yeah. Just
treason doesn't get a look at.
You know, if you're thinking of doing any treason, anyone, just watch Netflix or something instead.
There's better things on.
Absolutely. So look at the lovely draw distance too.
That's amazing.
London skyline there, isn't it nice?
Wow.
You've got like the Bank of England as well. That's another landmark. The River Thames, that's crazy, that's got like loads of...
It's a separate whole area, isn't it?
You have to actually free that area too. That's actually under mob rule, so you have to take that over. You name a London landmark, it's pretty much in here if it was around
the
at the time.
Eye.
Primark?
Yeah, Primark's in here. You can go to Primark and buy some an £8 pair
stuff.
Of jeans. Buy some cheap undies.
Yeah.
Good for socks. If you ever need socks.
Right, how long have we got left? Oh, we got a bit. So where's our next mission objective, Rich?
Well, Dan, if you want, you could go on the map. You could do one of the objectives for one of the many historical figures in the game, maybe.
Yeah, okay. Celebrities. Everyone likes celebrities.
Yeah, let's go and see Charles Dickens or someone like that, shall we? Or Karl Marx, that M there. You run to that M.
Where am I looking?
Up.
There.
So we could go and
let's go
do
see Karl.
Anarchist intervention for
let's
Karl
go
Marx.
See Karl.
So let's go and do one of those. Recruit asks, the animation seems really good. Is it pretty solid throughout the game? Yes, it is, Recruit. It's lovely.
Is it buggy?
Marvellous. I mean, one or two little bugs. I didn't come across anything major. And we haven't seen anything so far, have we?
No, I mean, because you know it sort of went through like a period where suddenly like the kind of free running got a bit like...
Yeah.
And it just wasn't like the original games where you were just like, this is amazing, look how cool I am, I don't hardly have to do anything.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it was still quite smooth. You're not, like,
I feel like it's a lot smoother than Unity was, and it feels like they've refined it a nice amount. There's still room for improvement, I think, but it's a definite, you know, step in the right direction. And the rope launch is actually cool. I was worried that the rope launch would be kind of redundant because, you know, you're an athletic, acrobatic, free runner
but
anyway.
But then saying that, they can kind of change how the city is, because whereas before you had to have everything almost on top of each other to run and jump, so now you can actually have kind of wider streets and longer distances.
Yeah, exactly. And also, if you get into a really tough situation and you want to get away fast, the rope launch is great. You can just go out there like Batman, just up onto the nearest rooftop, which is cool.
I mean, we'd all want a rope launcher in real life, if
exactly.
Someone would just give me one.
No, I'd love a rope launcher.
It's that weird thing of trusting it, though.
Yeah.
You know, like doing it, like, that's great, I've fired at the other wall.
I'd have to
Will
sort
it
of
take my weight?
Tug it a few times before I would, you know, trusted
commit
it.
Commit to it, yeah.
I was like, is there any more what's-its in here?
What's it? Who's got what's it?
Questions. Mitch wants us to climb Big Ben. Maybe we should do that.
Maybe let's end the stream with that. Huh? Maybe let's end the.
Yeah,
the
we'll
session.
End the stream for Mitch that way. Are there many missions like that Asylum one with multiple ways to kill the target, Hitman style? There's a whole bunch. In fact, I think every sequence ends with one. Denoted by a skull icon on the map. So there's pretty much every major assassin target you have to kill has one of those open-ended kind of missions.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. They're my favourite part of the game, I think.
My poor friend, Frank
Lawrence. Yeah, absolutely. I'd be happy if the whole of Assassin's Creed was just that.
That would be cool.
Yeah. Frank is consumed. Although I do kind of like these little side things like this.
I feel really rude walking off while he's still talking.
It is rude, Dan. You shouldn't do that.
Dan, you do that in real life.
Yeah, that is true.
You actually do that in real life. So I don't know why you're making out like you have manners.
Yeah, rude in video games. Fine in real life.
I'm just going to leave him.
Can a rope launcher save you when falling from a high building? No, it can't.
I thought it would.
The way it works now is because you press B to descend, it's seldom that you'll accidentally fall. The only time I ever fell is if I was climbing and someone shot me. And there's nothing you can do then. You're dead, basically. If you're high up enough, you're
what
done.
What station's that?
Good question. I have no idea.
It looks a bit like Paddington.
It could well be. I know King's Cross is in, and I know Charing Cross is in, so I don't know. This might be Paddington, you might be right.
I don't.
The period detail's lovely, very nice.
It's also visually there's a lot bloody of variety perfect. Going on.
Yeah, right.
Let's deal with this before Morris shows up.
Games, it all feels a bit
samey. Yeah.
This like actually feels like it's got a lot of depth and a lot of different colour and a lot of different areas to it.
I mean, I wasn't there at the time, but I feel like this is probably what it
was a bit
like.
Have you never seen when they do like the really old photographs and they paint them in all that kind of like weird colour?
Oh really? Oh, like colourised?
Yeah.
Yeah, photos of the time. Yeah, it's kind of like playing one of those, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, never thought of that.
It's weird because there is images for it, but you're so used to seeing the past in black and
exactly,
white, you can't
really
imagine it.
That's it. That's what they should have. They should have an unlockable black and white mode. Oh. Ubisoft, if you're listening.
There you go. So it feels super old-timey.
Absolutely. Ollie asks, can you get on the Hogwarts Express? No. Is Sherlock Holmes in this? No, because he's a fictional character. But then, so... And assassins, I guess. And
did you ever read that conspiracy theory about Harry Potter where actually it was just because he walked into a wall at the start of it, it was actually just all his like brain coma?
Yeah, I like that. That's good. I like that theory.
Ran into kind the of, wall like an idiot. Sometimes kind of ranking him. Like, run into the wall.
Kind of cheapens the whole thing at the end. Woke up and went, it's all a dream.
That's classic, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. So Dan, what you can do is if you press LB, you can get up to the roof and jump between carts.
Oh, okay.
No, there aren't actually.
Why aren't there any CD brothels?
I don't know. That's
there
a really
were
good
at
question.
That time. Well, like, you know, velvet red curtain places.
Yeah, and in Assassin's Creed, you used to have the courtesans and stuff that you could use to distract the guards.
Do you think it's because they're a bit like, you know, now they've got a female
maybe.
character,
yeah.
Let's just.
Yeah, maybe that's it.
Let's not open up
that
whole can of worms.
Avenue, yeah.
Although, to be honest with you, it is off the day.
Steady
yeah,
on.
Yeah, no, exactly. That's a glaring omission. That's terrible.
Never thought I'd say that. But
yeah, there we go.
There needs to be more brothels.
There needs to be more brothels, absolutely.
Right, so LB, right?
Left bumper, yeah, you can get up the roof and then you can jump to the other car and press B to hijack it.
It's actually in.
Go on.
In those days, the difference between, like, you know, if you were a gentleman, there'd be certain establishments that you wouldn't go into, certain
yes.
areas of London you that you wouldn't go into. But obviously, of that period, you could be anonymous, yeah. like, you know, gentlemen would kind of dress yeah. up to look a bit scruffy to go to, like, taverns and
absolutely.
Places like that.
That's a missed opportunity for a mission, isn't it?
Well, there's a lot of secretive stuff just in normal society because yeah. it was so prim and proper. There was so much more that was yeah. below what you would see on the surface.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
You know what you thought? In the Victorian era, it was actually very, very colourful. Like, you always think of it really
what
kind of down, like, grey.
Mark said.
Is he okay with me just next to him? No, I'm not sure.
Oh, you're fine.
So, yeah, sure.
It was only after Prince Albert died that
what do you expect me to do?
I went into mourning and everything became really dark.
Okay.
So actually, it used to be quite colourful before.
Right. Oh, that makes sense.
Like
wow,
what to do.
We got the right person to come up with.
I didn't know why I know any of this. I didn't even study
it's
history.
It's
and
good
I,
knowledge.
I did,
it's interesting, isn't it? Right, so yeah, we're actually carting nitroglycerin right now. So Dan needs to be careful. I don't know. I guess it must have been.
Can you put nitro on a horse?
Maybe. Maybe, maybe. Dan, can you do that?
Yes.
Give the horse some Red Bull. Let's watch it go.
Well, I'm not sure Red Bull was invented back in the 1800s.
Raw coffee with some gin.
I think they like meth back then, right?
You're going to be blown up if you're not more careful.
I'm going to make this explode, aren't I?
Careful, Dan, careful. Don't explode, please. That was close.
Easy.
So if you press left on the D-pad, you can switch to your pistol. It's a good way of getting those guys off your back. Although I think you're okay.
Well done. Turn right.
Keep going, keep going. Nearly there, Dan.
Keep moving. Come on. Oh my God, you can't steer. What is wrong with you?
I'm drunk.
Oh, that
again?
Makes perfect sense. Oh.
Go left.
Come on.
This is looking
a
little
dude
bit.
There. No!
This is looking dicey.
It's also
seen
incapable of actually just steering it when people are grabbing you.
Exactly. We're almost there. We've got to be there, surely.
Come on. Oh,
oh Dan. Are you doing all this on purpose to create tension?
No,
you're supposed to go right. Where are you? No! Where are you going?
Going?
Balls
there. No, I haven't. No. It's just part of the master plan.
Yeah, I think we're going to end up
exploding. This is why I will only ever get in a taxi with you.
Yeah, exactly.
Look, it worked perfectly.
Oh, it did. Yeah,
it's textbook.
Are we there yet?
God, no.
Come on, Dan.
Oh.
Come on.
Yes.
Not much further,
oh.
surely.
Oh. Come on.
This looks like
straight.
It.
Who are these people?
Now
you've
got to defend,
like
defend.
You've got to defend him from snipers.
Who's the stun? Oh, you've ruined it.
Right, you need to take out all these guys
oh,
now.
Oh my God.
Get
just
off the horse.
Over. Run over.
Jump off, jump off, jump off.
Now just stab him off. There we go.
Do you know how to avoid bullets?
Where it says the big Y above
yeah,
my head.
Exactly.
The clue was in the prompt on the screen.
This guy didn't seem that interesting.
No, right? Where's he going?
He just like age of 47.
What are they doing there?
He's
is
getting
he
away.
Running off?
Is he just,
oh, wow.
I'm supposed to defend that guy. Yeah.
Is that it? Has he just stole my...
Kill.
Oh, there's still one person left.
Where?
Up there.
Oh, there.
Oh,
there you go.
Yeah.
Let's do this.
Just shoot.
You could rope the answer, rope launch up, do a nice air assassination.
Oh, no, that's too far.
Yeah.
That's too far.
Right, overkill.
I don't know, that might be a good vantage point.
There we go.
Can you do it from there?
Right.
I think you're too high up, Dan.
Dan.
How about from there?
Go on, Dan. Just jump on him.
No. Down a bit. Try that little
You're
metal
not really selling this as like
thing.
A smooth introduction.
Oh, I am.
Go on there, surely. Yep, there you go. Perfect. There we go.
You're a vice supervisor.
Right. Let's finish off by visiting Big Ben.
Well, you want to speak to the anarchist first and complete the mission.
We don't.
Yeah, you do. You've come this far, you might as well.
Well, mate, how's it going?
Have a chat.
Hey, friend.
I got the nitro back. That must please you.
How far's Big Ben from here?
Not far. You can fast travel there if you want.
Should we fast travel?
Well, actually, if you fast travel there, you'll be on top of Big Ben already.
Tell me where that's.
So maybe fast travel to the nearest fast travel point.
Find me in Southwark when you're ready.
People in the chat saying that they wanted to see you explode.
Yeah, I think that was quite selfish of you not
I'm sorry I disappointed. Yeah.
So Dan, if you just call up the map again.
Can we not see Big Ben from here?
It depends what district you're in. I don't think so. Just hit the map button. Yeah, no, you're nowhere near. So go over to the left. So down a bit. Down.
Is that it?
Yeah, it's a bit further
there.
From that place where we ate like 8 Burger Kings by the river. Yeah. Do you remember that?
I do remember that.
So you could fast travel to the Thames there and then leg it along.
Where
maybe.
There?
So up a bit. You see that one up there? They're fast forward symbols, Dan.
Oh, okay, there.
So yeah, that's it. Sorry, I should have said that. So yeah, if you just hit fast travel and yeah.
Right, and then we'll run, we'll climb, and we'll all be good.
Rammer Man bought this game today. Good for you, Rammer. You're going to have a.
Has anybody bought the game
time.
Yet?
Yeah, has anyone got it?
Is anyone interested?
Anyone actually bought the game?
Anyone intending to? One,
one.
Two, three, two. Four, five, six.
Have you guys
seven,
played
eight,
all the other games
nine,
as
ten.
Well?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Cool.
Are you excited that it's in London?
I am. But it's nice to be in London and have London accents as opposed to being in France and having London accents.
That's a good thing about the game. There's no Dick Van Dyke.
No,
of,
right.
All right, cool, blimey, geez.
It's
there's none of that, no.
But what are some of the names, though? What is it? Bloody Nora, right?
There is a character called Bloody Nora, yes.
Maybe she was the original one.
Yeah, Bloody
maybe.
Nora.
Maybe that's where it came from.
I don't know. That can happen.
Whee! Right, go for a swim in the pooey Thames water.
Where's Big Ben?
I mean,
all
they really had to do to like kill them off is just like put some spikes in like bales
in
of
the
hay.
Bales of
like
hay,
like
yeah.
One by one, you systematically kill them off without having to do anything.
That's what I want to know. Is there ever going to be an Assassin's Creed game without carts of hay to conveniently
Here's
dive into?
Wait, aren't
yeah.
there leaves in
oh,
this?
Oh, you're going to get run over by a giant? No, no!
There's hay and leaves.
Look at that, just hitch a ride.
Yeah, there you go.
Take me to the Thames, sir.
Oh. So the Thames is pretty busy.
No, the wrong boat. Take me the wrong boat.
Oh, you got some bobbies on you, mate. Bobbies. Take them down. That's just harsh, isn't it?
Yeah, the thing is, though, really, actually, if you just went to the Thames, you'd probably be dead. There's so much, like, cholera,
yeah, I know.
Dead
yeah.
animals and
Absolutely.
There.
Look at this, though. We've got a nice tour of London.
It's amazing. You see, obviously, the Thames at that time would be super busy.
Yeah,
it's now turned into Frogger.
Yeah, exactly right. Assassin's Creed Frogger edition.
Let's see if we can get across without touching the water.
Wow. Is that the challenge you set for yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that can be done.
So my dad used to swim in the Thames.
Did he really?
When he was a boy, he said there were just like dead horses and stuff
floating
down the river. How he didn't catch some sort of weird disease.
Dead horses.
Yeah, but
how did they end up in there?
We just like chuck everything in the river. It's like an easy way to get rid of rubbish.
Wasn't someone like riding a horse on a boat and it just died on the boat and they're like, oh, chuck it in the chuck
come
it
on,
in the
come
tent.
On. But you probably had to pay to get it removed. You just threw it in the tent. Like basically the equivalent flight of it.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, that seems to be the case.
I might struggle here.
Anything else other than dead horses that he came across?
Oh, failed.
Oh, damn. Boom.
Ah, you've ruined it. You start Assassin's Creed Frogger.
So that's a detail missing from this game, dead, floating dead
there,
animals.
There was a lot
in the
of stuff in the, a lot of stuff in the river. As well as some food.
Yeah.
Because they had open sewer systems.
Yeah, damn. Think of what you're swimming through.
That's not me.
Yeah, it wasn't until like there was one year where basically it was like a really hot summer and the entirety of London stank. And then they were like, maybe we should invest in some covered sewers.
Was that last year?
Yeah, but It's called the Great Stink Worm.
Oh, really?
Like, yeah.
Oh,
wow.
How do you know all this?
I don't know. Genuinely don't know. What I did yesterday.
It's good stuff to have stored away. You know.
This is literally the only time it's been in any use.
Exactly, but it's not wasted, is it? Here we go then. This is for you, Mitch, alright?
Let's do it. Get up that bad boy.
As this is the Victorian era, Ozan asks, which is well known for its industry, can you create gadgets in this similar to creating bombs in previous games? You can craft things and upgrade things, but you get things crafted for you. Like when you meet Alexander Graham Bell, he crafts...
Does he give you a mobile phone?
He doesn't.
Because he should.
That would be good though, wouldn't it?
Or is it just a tin can with a bit
yeah,
of string
tin can,
and you've got
you
to get like,
around
the tension
with it.
Right?
Yeah. He gives you like electronic bombs that fire like kind of Tesla-y things. I don't think he was, but...
I don't think he had anything to do with that.
There is some sort of narrative reasoning. And
I find it quite funny with Assassin's Creed, right? They you know, they hire historians for these games to like get things like really right, and then they just go bonkers in another direction with
other stuff. Well, it seems to me they kind of think, okay, this was the actual historical stuff, but what can we do to make it more fun?
Way more interesting.
Or interesting, yeah.
They should hire the horrible history guys. Yeah. They're really good.
That would be good. Yes, they play a little fast and loose with it, but you know.
Makes it a bit more interesting.
There we go.
Exactly. So you can synchronize that point again if you want.
Let's take in the view.
Pressing B. Oh, maybe not.
But yeah, so look at that.
That's amazing.
So there
and
we go.
It's Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
From the top of Big Ben.
Let's finish it off with a dive.
Yeah, go on.
The thing is, though, there are actually people online on YouTube who do weird stuff like this and then film themselves, and I can't even bear it.
Look at that.
Oh, yeah, it's insane.
Like the guy who ropes, did they just hang off with like an arm and like, what if you got a sweaty hand?
Exactly, what if you just slip?
Look, leaves.
What if you have a twitch?
Yeah.
Oh, leaves, right, not hay. Oh, okay. Leaves, because it's London.
Okay,
oh,
good.
Yeah, right, sorry.
Yes, thank you very much, folks. That was Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which is out now for, is it just current gen only? Or
yes.
So Xbox One, PS4.
PS4 and PC. Yeah.
And that's out now. We'll be back in about 5 minutes with the Geekatorium. Thank you very much, folks.
Thank
See you soon.